Yeah. What do you think of coconut amino?
Love it. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yes. Okay, so coconut aminos, liquid aminos, this is very similar to soy sauce. So liquid aminos has about half the sodium of low sodium soy sauce. It's about 40% less sodium than low sodium soy sauce, and this one is about 50% less sodium than low sodium soy sauce. It's a little bit sweeter than this one.
You like them.
It doesn't taste like coconut though, but it definitely is really good. I love both of them, to be honest. I have both of them at home.
Oh. So you said this one's still good, right?
Oh yeah, they're both great. Yeah, I love them both.
Put them on my avocado.
Yeah, that sounds great. This one's really, really great. Yeah. I'll put it on my salmon. Have you guys tried stevia, or do you use stevia? Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. The thing about stevia is not all of it is actually stevia. Like, this has like very little traces of stevia in it. This actually is not stevia either. So the liquid stevia is the best one to go with.
No, that is crazy.
It says stevia on it.
I
buy that one, the stevia
that?
In the raw. Yeah. Okay. I just assumed it was because
it's so deceiving.
What it's called.
So, yeah, exactly. Crazy. Right. The first ingredient is maltodextrin, which is a sugar alcohol, and then it says stevia leaf extract underneath it. So it might be 5% stevia, and the first ingredient is maltodextrin.
So you recommend to get the little jars of the liquid.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's actually, I know they're expensive for the little jars, but you can get 4 ounces. The 2 ounces is what they have here, but you can get 4 ounces from Vitacost.com, and they usually have buy one, get one half off or buy one, get one free. So it only ends up being like $6 for 4 ounces versus 2 ounces for like $10 here. And it lasts forever.
So what do you think of like those pumpkin seed tortilla chips? Those probably aren't good just because they're
processed. Yeah, nutritional.
The one in your cart.
Those are cookies, but
you're forgiven. I won't tell anyone. Nutritionally, they have the same nutritional profile as like regular tortilla chips. It's like just like a hair better. So at the end of the day, if you're eating them because they're better for you, I'm just gonna stay with the regular one because it's not really worth it. Because you're more likely eat something, a lot more of something, if you think it's good for you, than if you know that it's bad for you. So at the end of the day, like,
just treat it.
Be honest with you, you're probably gonna eat half a container of Edie's, half fat, because you know it's not as bad for you if you're gonna have, than if you're gonna have like Godiva or like something really much more decadent, like ice cream wise, so, or Häagen-Dazs.
For your next, can you do baklava?
No.
A healthy baklava, that would actually be awesome.
No,
if it's possible.
The thing is, phyllo dough is, there's not really,
you can't.
Yes, it's not really bad for you, but it still is made with like white bleached flour. So
you're not going to do it in your new book?
No. I grew up with my mom making baklava like all the time. She used to actually sell it. All these dressings, although they look enticing, I used to actually have these too. The yogurt dressings, they have so many chemicals in them. So here's a tip. So if you want something creamy and a dressing, put some Greek yogurt and whatever the heck you want in it. I like putting some mustard, Greek yogurt, and some seasonings with it. This is like one of my favorite sections because everyone's like, oh, juice, it's so healthy for you. Why do I even need to eat a meal when I can just grab one of these naked drinks? Okay, so if I'm going to grab this red machine, it has 50 grams of sugar and 340 grams of calories, or 240 calories, and only 2 grams of protein, or no, sorry, 4. Yeah, so 50 grams of sugar later with this naked red machine, I mean all these drinks. First of all, let's go to the top section. Who here has coffee in the morning? Hey! Hey for coffee. What do you guys have in your coffee in the morning?
Wow.
I don't know. So I went to half an hour for a while, but I missed it.
I love flavored coffee. I usually go for my go-to one is right here. This is the one I have. I know, and it probably has so many chemicals, but I love
that. That also has carrageenan in it.
Does it?
Yeah. I'm going to look for that one now.
Carrageenan.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's a little tip for people who like coffee. Some stevia, give it that little pizzazz that like a coffee bean can, but it won't overpower it. Coffee bean is wonderful, especially all the crazy things they have. But yeah, I know. In reality, like, no, it's not gonna taste like almond joy coffee bean. Like, let's be honest here. I can drink the whole thing. It's scary. Have you ever thought about making your own?
No.
Or almond?
Oh, I've seen it, but I've never tried it.
So instead of like going through the whole process of soaking your nuts and all that stuff, literally just put like a tablespoon of almond butter in your blender with like a cup or half a cup of water.
Cool.
We have instant
almond butter.
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
Wow.
Yeah.
Water.
And if you want to sweeten it, put some sweetener in it, some stevia, honey.
Yeah, that's it.
So instead of having to spend $3 on a huge thing of it, you know, almond butter is a little more expensive. You can make your own now. But in reality, it's so much easier. Just like a tablespoon.
So what is an almond milk that's not good?
Natural flavors, which who knows what that is. Since we live in America, they can hide so much stuff in here and they don't even let us know what's in here. But the fact that it's literally the second ingredient in here, like, what is it? Lactose bean gum, which is a thickener of some sort. Sunflower lecithin, which is a thickener. Gallan gum, I personally don't know what that is. Added vitamins and minerals, and then the allergen statement contains almonds produced in a factory with coconut and all this other stuff. I don't know, like just reading all that stuff to me, if I could avoid it, why not? If I can do something just as simple as putting almond butter, which is should be just roasted almonds and maybe salt, in my blender and avoid all these chemicals, and it's cheaper, easier, more convenient.
So could I find, like if I was to Google that, could I find like how much almond butter to how much milk?
Yeah, and you can play around with it. There's no rhyme or reason. Like just play around with it and make it your own. Yeah. So
is there anything natural that I can add as a step of a thickener?
As a thickener? Why would she
be? I'm just saying.
What if she doesn't?
What if she doesn't?
Oh, it's watered down already.
If you make, so I'm just thinking like if she won't drink it. Maybe it's not right, yeah.
At the end of the day, if you make real almond milk, it's so much thicker than this.
So it is.
It's like comparing whole milk to skim. It's so creamy. You soak it over, you just want to soak the almonds overnight, and you put them in a food processor, the blender, and then you strain it through like a milk cloth, and it gets super thick and creamy. It's just half and half thing that comes out. And then you get this, and you're like, when you pour it, it's like clear. So they water this down so much, it's ridiculous. So the real, if you want to make real almond milk, it's one part to four parts of water. So one cup of almonds, and then four cups of water. Put it in your blender, you let it go, and then you strain it through a sieve, or like a muslin cloth, or a cheese cloth, and then you have your almond milk. It only lasts in your fridge for 2 to 3 days. It'll separate, you can mix it up. But a quick convenient way to do it is literally just a tablespoon of almond butter, some water in your blender, that's all.
Yeah.
Like, and like I said, 1 cup to 1 tablespoon is going to be creamy. If you want it to be more watery, it's going to be more water. Just play around with it. It's not like you're going to be wasting an entire jar of almond butter, you know what I mean? Just try it one time, taste it, you know, it's okay.